Meanwhile, Britain's Labour Party renews its call for an early general election. The opposition party's deputy leader, Angela Rayner, scored the Tories' supposed coronation of incoming Prime Minister Rishi Sunak. Rayner says Sunak does not have the people's mandate after he was previously rejected by his party in favour of Liz Truss.
The Conservatives have completely broken their promises, broke our economy, and now they want to see a general election. They can't just keep doling out prime ministers every month because they're in total chaos. What we've seen played out is a coronation here and not an actual election where people have a mandate to serve the British people of this country.
A busy day for British politics as Rishi Sunak is set to formally take over as UK Prime Minister. Tuesday's events begin with his predecessor, Liz Truss, leading her final cabinet meeting at 9 a.m. UK time. She will then make a speech outside 10 Downing Street before traveling to Buckingham Palace to formally submit her resignation to King Charles III. Afterwards, Sunak will hold his first audience with the King, where he will be asked to form a government. After that, Sunak officially becomes a new Prime Minister and will then travel to Downing Street to give a statement. In a speech Monday, Sunak vowed to bring stability and unity to Britain in a time of economic crisis.
It is the greatest privilege of my life to be able to serve the party I love and give back to the country I owe so much to. The United Kingdom is a great country, but there is no doubt we face a profound economic challenge. We now need stability and unity, and I will make it my utmost priority to bring our party and our country together.
The former Treasury chief will be the third UK Prime Minister this year and the first person of colour to hold the post. Scores of fatalities reported in Myanmar after the military junta launched an airstrike on a concert organized by a rebel group. According to local media, at least 50 people were killed in the strike in Kachin State. The event was organized by the Kachin Independence Army, which has resisted the junta since it overthrew Myanmar's civilian government in 2021. The United Nations has condemned the attack. It says the use of excessive force by government troops against unarmed civilians is unacceptable. Another shooting tragedy in the U.S. Two people are killed and several others injured after a gunman opened fire at a high school in the city of St. Louis in Missouri. The gunman, who appeared to be about 20 years old, was then shot dead by responding police officers. Police have yet to identify the suspect or his motive. This is the latest in a string of school shootings in the U.S. One of the deadliest took place in May when a gunman killed 19 children and two teachers at an elementary school in Uvalde, Texas. At least four Palestinians have been killed during a raid by Israeli security forces in the West Bank. 21 others were injured, four of whom are in serious condition. Israel said the raid was conducted on a hideout allegedly used as a headquarters by a terrorist group. The deadly raid triggered protests in the West Bank, where a fifth person was shot dead by Israeli soldiers. For months, Israel has been regularly raiding cities in the West Bank, saying it is targeting militants and their weapons stockpiles. But human rights groups say dozens of unarmed civilians have also been killed.